بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات وبفضله تتنزل الخيرات والبركات وبتوفيقه تتحقق المقاصد والغايات والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبي الرحمة وإمام الهدى محمد بن عبد الله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Respected علماء Imam Siraj al-Ahad, Ustaz al-Ahad Tareem, Sheikh Abdul Majid, elders, sisters, brothers, and children. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Maryam. She is 3.5 years old, my daughter. She insisted that she come with me on the stage. So I said, no problem, mashallah. So Maryam will be here. So try not to get too distracted by their mashallah cuteness. So a few minutes I would like to share with you this very important topic, and then I will leave the stage to hear from our distinguished sheikhs and scholars, bismillah. The purpose of our existence and our role in the creation. It's a very heavy topic, very dense topic, mashallah, but a very important and beneficial one. The purpose of our existence and our role in the creation. So as I was reflecting on my talk, the thoughts that I wanted to present to you, I was able to boil down this topic into two questions. And hopefully by the end of this brief talk, we'll have some clarity about these two questions. The two questions that arise when we address this topic are the following. Number one, who created us? Who created us? And number two, why are we here? So who made us? And what on earth are we doing here on earth? Everything, respected brothers and elders, has an originator, has a creator, has a maker. All of existence has a creator. And this creator, of course, is uncreated. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes himself as the fashioner, the designer. فَاطِرُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the one who designed and fashioned all of existence, the heavens and the earth. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala very comprehensively in an ayah that many of us know. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2 in the Qur'an, Ayah number 30. The purpose of life and our role here in this dunya and this world. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. O Prophet, when your Lord told the angels that I am putting a successor on earth. I am putting a successor on earth. Another translation, I indeed will make upon the earth a successive authority. Khalifa is a representative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, center. So Allah says, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ. جَاعِل means to make or create. So Allah is creating us. This means He is the creator. So He's telling us there that I am the maker, your maker. And then He says, فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. He describes our role here on earth. Why are we here? What's the purpose of life and existence? It is to represent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here to all of existence and the creation of humanity. Respected brothers and sisters and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, in Surah Al-Anbiya, very beautifully, وَمَا خَلَقَنَا السَّمَاءَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا لَاعِبِينَ. We did not create the heavens and the earth and everything in between for fun and games and play. We didn't create this beautiful earth, this beautiful universe, just for play or playfully. Everything in existence has a purpose. We have a purpose. We have a significant role to fulfill here on earth. وَمَا خَلَقْنَاهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ We created them for a true purpose, but most people do not comprehend. Allah says that we created you for a reason. مَا خَلَقْنَاهُمَا إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ We have a true purpose to fulfill here on earth. وَلَكِنْ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But unfortunately, most people don't understand their purpose in life. This is why we are chasing this dunya, this world, as if it is the end goal itself. Money, property, fame, position, power, you name it. And we think that that is only it here in life, and there is nothing else beyond it. As our beloved Qadi Shaykh Abdul Majid recited from Surah Al-Hadid, اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو In آخر الآية, Allah describes the fun and games that people are engrossed with in life. Acquiring wealth, amassing property, chasing after fame. And all of this, Allah says, is just transient. It is a delusion. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ This is all fake. It's all artificial. The real purpose in life, it is to know the Creator, and obey the Creator. So now we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, even logically speaking. There can't be somebody before the Creator, because then that's going to be a never-ending cycle. There has to be a beginning. هو الأول He is فليس قبله شيء There is no one being before him. ولم يكن له كفوا أحد There is none comparable to him. So once we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us. This will motivate us to hopefully know who He is. If we don't know who Allah is, then how can we fulfill our purpose that He sent us here to earth with? So number one, it is very important, respected brothers, sisters, and elders, in this world, after acknowledging and expressing faith in the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is imperative for us to know the responsibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us to this world with. He says towards the end of Surah Al-Thariyat, an ayah that many of us are familiar with. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ If we ask Allah, oh Allah, why did you make us? Why did you create us? He says, I have not created jinn and human beings other than to worship me. So we are sent to this world, respected brothers, sisters, and elders, to worship and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm not going to go into what is ibadah and obedience and all of that. In short, it is to do everything that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is to do all kinds of good and righteous actions, whether it is as small as sharing a beautiful, smiling, cheerful face, something as small as moving a harmful object from the road, whether it is to hold the door open for someone, to give up your seat, to help someone in need, to help somebody board their vehicle, whether it is to serve your parents, or to offer your prayers, to fast in Ramadan, to perform Hajj once in your lifetime, whether it is to spend in the path of Allah and participate in good causes, whatever it is, all of that comprises, if you have a sincere intention, to please Allah, this is part of ibadah. Even when you're at the park, I like to talk to the youth and tell them that when you're at the park playing basketball, when you're playing football, and you refrain from cursing when somebody fouls you, Imam Siraj, you know what I'm talking about. Imam Siraj al-Hajj is a professional basketball player, mashallah. He could have been playing with the Brooklyn Nets, but he is full-time da'i, mashallah, teaching us here in America and the ummah worldwide, mashallah. You know, perhaps even the Knicks could have really benefited from him. We make dua for the New York Knicks. May Allah give them tawfiq to, in our lifetime, ya Allah, win a championship. I mean, ya Allah, if the Toronto Raptors could have done it, then I don't know about the Knicks. They definitely got to catch up. MashaAllah. So, coming back, as I close, respected brothers, sisters, and elders. Once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told his beloved young companion, Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, that, Ya Mu'adh, O Mu'adh, أتدري ما حق الله على العباد؟ Do you know what is Allah's right over his slave, his servant? وما حق العباد على الله؟ And you know the right that the slave of Allah has over Allah? And then Mu'adh replied, Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger know best. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّ حَقُّ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا. The right that Allah has over his slave, his servant, is that his slave worships him without joining any partners with him in worship. So when we devote to Allah, we don't associate any other beings, entities, or creatures within that worship. And the right that we have over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that when we worship Allah properly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us a Jannah paradise. This is the two-way relationship that we have. We worship Allah without any partners, and then He forgives us and grants us a Jannah. This is our purpose in life, to live a good, healthy, wholesome, meaningful life, a life full of productivity, a life that is worthwhile, not getting distracted by the fun and games, and not making work, life, family, education the end goal itself, but in fact using those as a means to attaining the true end goal, which is the pleasure and the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire us, to guide us, and to protect us. Say Ameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq to know Him and worship Him properly here in this world. Say Ameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to benefit from everything that we shall hear this weekend here at UNO Convention 2019. Say Ameen. I invite everyone here to not miss a single session from this beautiful program that we have set up for you guys. Take advantage of every moment. Take advantage of every lecture. Try to attend and be up front, center, away from distractions. Put away or silence your gadgets so that you can concentrate and take in everything that the speakers have to offer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grants us His pleasure and His highest levels of paradise in the Akhirah. Ameen. I end with one short dua. The Prophet taught his beloved companion Mu'adh, and I will leave the stage. The following dua, I want you to repeat after me. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Mu'adh, I love you for the sake of Allah. Ya Mu'adh, inni uhibbu, I love you for the sake of Allah. SubhanAllah. It's the man that the Prophet is telling you, I love you for the sake of Allah. How special do you think Mu'adh felt? And then he says, Mu'adh, after each prayer, don't forget to recite the following dua, which is Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatika. Everybody repeat after me. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatika. Oh Allah, help me remember you, thank you, and worship you in the best manner possible. With this, hopefully, we can know our Creator and fulfill our role here in this world. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.